Welcome to our class. One more time, this is Learning with Dr. Linda. We're continuing with our conversation on the schools of organizational change. And today we're going to be looking at the open systems, the school of organizational change that looks at organizations, not necessarily from the aspect of the individuals within the organization or the groups within the organization, but more so from the perspective of the elements within the organization. This school of organizational change looks at organizations as being open systems that are affected directly by the environment. And prior, I've talked to you about the force field analysis, where you look at the forces affecting the organization in terms of those that are supportive of the organizational change and those that are of detriment to the organizational change. So for today's class, we're going to be learning about a model called McKinsey 7S model, and it is going to be illustrating to us what to expect when we think about open systems or to look at organizations from an open systems. I'm going to share my slides so that you can walk with me through this. Learning with Dr. Linda, this is Dr. Linda Kimensu. Right, there you go. So this kind of a change management model or the change perspective or what you've been referring to as the school of organizational change views organizations to be composed of a number of interconnected subsystems. So the organization is not just made up of the people, but also there are other subsystems such as the strategy, the structure, the systems within that organization, the processes, the culture, the technical skills, etc. And all these things have an influence on how change is managed. So the approach to this change management is based on the understanding that the change of an organization can be made through the change of the subsystems. And as I mentioned earlier, those subsystems could be goals, values, and technical skills. It relies on the input-output model, of which it's affected by the environment. So the input comes from the environment, there's the process, and then there's the output that goes back to the environment. Now, we're going to be looking at the McKinsey 7S model. And McKinsey is a model that was named after this consulting company in the United States called McKinsey and Company in 1980, and which conducts applied research in research and industry. And it was developed to provide strategies on how various components of the organization work together. The application of the model is that this model, once it is used, and we have several examples of how this model has been used in different organizations, in different industries, more specifically, especially in Kenya, it has been used in the banking industry, it has been used in the airline industry, it has been used in different corporations. And the goal of this model is so that the organization can be able to align the different structures, systems, processes with performance by evaluating to see which of these elements has the greatest or the least effect on performance so that the organization can plan accordingly. The application of this model can also help an organization understand its core activities or the most influential factors in organizational strategy. So they're able to look at the model and understand which of these factors has the greatest weight as regards to how the organization performs. The model also helps the organization to realign itself to new strategies or to realign itself to adopt new organizational designs. And also it helps in evaluating how the organization is relating in terms of the systems, the structures, the processes, etc. Now, when you look at this model, I wanted to look at it just briefly and sort of see there if those elements are not haphazardly placed. I would want you to reflect on them. And for some moment, just ask yourself, why do we have the hard S's, for instance, being on top? And where do we have the soft S's being on the bottom? And where do we have the shared values sort of in being interconnected with all the other S's? So I would want you to reflect on that a little bit. I would also want you to look at this and just for a moment, ask yourself, what do hard S's refer to? And what do the soft S's refer to? Now, the hard S's are strategy, structure, and systems. Now, one of the things that you need to understand about the hard S's is that these S's are tangible and you can easily identify them. When you go to an organization, you can actually know the structure by looking at the organizational chart. You can tell who is reporting to who by reviewing the organizational chart. You can tell an organizational strategy by reviewing their strategic planning. Their strategic plans. You can tell what kind of objectives they have within a year or even 5 years. You can tell the kind of systems that the organization has by what you see. You can tell whether an organization has automated their systems or whether their systems are manual. Even when you go to a bank, you can easily tell the kind of systems that the organization is using. So the hard S's are those things that are easy to identify. They are also those things that the management can easily manipulate. Of course, they are costly in terms of financial, the finances, but they are things that an organization can quickly and easily manipulate, you know, in terms of coming up with new strategies in a strategic plan, reorganizing the structure, maybe automating the systems, etc. Now, on the other hand, we have the soft S's. The soft S's, we could say, they're those things that are not easily identifiable, and you'd have to relate with the organization a little bit more to get to understand. They are bound by the culture of the organization. So once you've interacted with members of the organization for a while, that's when you can be able to actually tell the kind of skills they have, both hard skills and soft skills. You can tell their communication skills. You can tell their negotiation skills by interacting with those people. So they are not outright. You'll have to interact with people to get to know this. You'd have to interact with people to know the kind of culture that is in the organization. Is it open? Is it closed? The kind of management style, the staff. Now, one of the things you need to know is all of these factors are important, whether hard S's or soft S's. Some organizations may be relying on some more than others, but that doesn't mean that you can do without either the hard or the S's. And as you see in this image, there's a lot of interconnectivity. A change of the structure can result to change in values and can also result to change in staff. For instance, if you want to adopt a flat structure within an organization, it would mean that you'll have to do away with some members of the staff. Once you do away with some members of the staff, that can actually affect the culture depending on how the aspect of redundancies or how the structure was made linear or made flatter, the culture, the shared values that they're going to be changed or they're going to be altered because of that strategy. So Each of these S's is affected directly by the other S. A change in management style could be a strategy that an organization has, and that actually formulates the values that the organizations have. So as you see, the shared values are at the middle, because a change of either of the S's alters the values or is altered by the values of what we call the culture of the organization. So the hard S's, we talk of the strategy, the structure, the systems. Strategy is about what kind of tactics do organizations use to align their resources and capabilities so as to get the competitive edge within their market. Strategies could be like what we see in Michael Porter, you know, differentiation strategy, niche strategy, focus strategy, you know, unsolved strategy. You know, all those are strategies that organizations adopt so that they can be able to align their resources with the environment so that they can win the market share and have some competitive edge. Our structure is how the organization is organized, who reports to who, what kind of spans of control do the organizations have, what kind of organizational structures or charts do they have? Is it a line structure? Is it staff? Is it military? Is it product structure? Is it division structure? And how are the roles, responsibilities, accountabilities assigned within that structure? Who reports to who? The systems refer to the infrastructure. Is it manual? Is it automated? The business and the technical infrastructure. When we look at the soft skills, we're looking at the shared values, the style, the staff, and the skill set. The shared values is more like the culture, the norms, the socialization, the traits, the behaviors, the characteristics that the organization believes in. And some of these things can be stipulated in the vision and the mission statement, but also you're going to see it in how people behave. You're going to see the core values. Do they value integrity, confidentiality, autonomy? You're going to see all that in how they behave, in their characteristics, but also it could be stipulated in the mission and the vision. The style, here we're looking at the management style or the leadership style. Are you in an autocratic environment? Is it authoritarian? Is it laissez-faire? What kind of management style is adopted within that organization? And of course, leadership and the management and also the followers, all these people come together and they form a management style. Is the staff, you know, who makes up the employees? What are the staffing plans? How do organizations tap talent? How do they recruit? How do they retain talent? How do they develop their human resource? What kind of remunerations do they give their human resource? How do they select their human resource? And all these have an influence on the kind of change management that they have. And finally, we have the skills, the ability to do the organization's work. What kind of skills do we see within these staff members? Are they empowered? Do they have the hard skills, the technical skills to do the job? But also, do they have the soft skills required to communicate effectively, to handle conflict management, to do negotiations, to do leadership? What kind of skills are within this organization? And of course, now the application of the model, there are those questions that you could ask in terms of strategy. What kind of strategy is the organization seeking to accomplish? How does the organization plan to use its resources? What makes the organization unique? You know, what is distinct about that organization? How does the organization compete? How does it adapt? All that, the answers to those questions can tell you the kind of strategy that the organization is to adopt. Then when you look at the structure, we're going to be looking at how is the organization organized? What kind of reporting and working relationships are there? How do people align themselves with the strategy? Does the structure support strategy? How are decisions made? Is it mostly centralized, decentralized? empowerment? How is information shared within the organization? And then when you look at the systems, you're looking at the automation, the manual systems, the controls, the monitoring and evaluation, the rules and procedures, the shared values, the mission, the vision, the ideal values vis-a-vis the real values, the founding values of the management. And then we look at the style, we're looking at the management and leadership style. Do they have an open system? Do they have a closed system? How do employees respond to management? How does management respond to the employees? What is encouraged within the organization? Is it competition, collaboration, or cooperation? What kind of behaviors, tasks, or deliverables do the management or leadership reward? And all of this can actually tell you the kind of culture that the organization has. In terms of staff, the size of the organization, the staffing needs, the gaps, you know, the plans, the skill set, are there gaps, what is the organization known to be doing so well in, etc. So it's very important as an organization that deals with change management to reflect on these essays and find out what are some of the gaps we have within the organization. And when we're analyzing the 7 essays, this is the goal. We want to see the level of consistency, the level of alignment. Is there conflict within the essays? Are there gaps? Do the essays support each other? What are the strengths? What are the weaknesses? So those are that is the reason why we have the 7 S's, sort of evaluate issues, consistency, alignment, conflict, gaps, support, strength, and weaknesses. I would want you to review your own organization and sort of look at the 7 S's as relates to your organization. How do the 7 S's relate to one another? Are there consistencies? Are they aligned to the strategy? Are they aligned to the core values, to the vision and the mission statements of the organization? Do you perceive any conflicts or gaps, and how can they be handled? What are the strengths that you have in terms of the S's, and how can you strengthen them? And what can you continue minimizing as your weaknesses? So that marks the end of our class today. Yes, thank you very much. Until then, I'm wishing you all a very good time as we get to our next class. Goodbye.